happy is the mother who bore you and nursed you?
Rather, how happy are those who hear the word of God and obey it?
Teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples.
When you pray, say, Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us day by day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, for we also forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
In the Holy Scriptures, God declared the Messiah would come to be the Savior of the world. The life of Jesus gives evidence that he is indeed the one the prophets spoke about. Isaiah prophesied that the virgin will conceive a child and will give birth to a son. Centuries later, the birth of Jesus was the fulfillment of that prophecy. The Holy Scriptures declared that the Holy One to be born would be called the Son of God. This means that Jesus was to be called the Son of God in a spiritual sense. We see this in how he lived his life. He healed people from disease, forgave their sins, turned them back to God, and promised them a place in God's eternal kingdom. He offered himself as a sacrifice for sin in their place, and then rose again, conquering death. Jesus said, "No one can take my life from me. I lay it down of my own accord." The life of Jesus not only fulfilled the writings of the prophets, but also confirmed the truth of God's holy word. The prophets declared, "The word of the Lord is flawless. Your word, O Lord, is eternal." Jesus himself said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away." Jesus came to give us life in all its fullness. But when man disobeyed God in the Garden of Eden, he chose to go his own way, and his actions separated him from the Creator. The Holy Scriptures declare that all have sinned, and the payment for sin is death. This means a spiritual death, eternal separation from God. But just as God provided a ram to die in place of Abraham's son, so he sent Jesus the Messiah to die in our place. His life, death, and resurrection restored the relationship between God and all those who put their trust in him. Now, those who follow Jesus not only have their sins forgiven, but are saved from God's eternal judgment. They are assured of paradise and will live with him forever. It is this life and freedom from the guilt and power of sin that Jesus offers each person today. This does not mean following a religion, but choosing to have faith in Jesus, who says, "I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him." This means turning to God and trusting Jesus to come into our lives, to forgive our sins, and to make us what he wants us to be. It is not enough to intellectually agree with his claims, nor to have an emotional experience. We receive him by grace through faith as an act of the will. When people are ready to become followers of Jesus the Messiah, they may speak to him in a simple prayer. Perhaps you are ready now to open your life to God. If so, you may join in the following prayer to him, silently, in your heart. Lord Jesus, I need you. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I confess and repent of my sins. I open the door of my life and receive you as my Savior and Lord. Thank you for forgiving my sins and giving me eternal life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. As I become one of your followers. Amen. Jesus said about his followers, "My sheep recognize my voice. I know them, and they follow me." In order to experience the abundant life which Jesus promised, his followers talk to God each day in prayer and read or listen to his word. They tell others about him and meet regularly with those who love and follow him. Remember his wonderful promise. All power is given to me in heaven and in earth. Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world.
老师啊，我求你教导我们该怎么祷告，好不好？你们要这样祷告：我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿门。
很久以前，先知们就在历史书上写道：“神要赐下弥赛亚来拯救罪人，使他们与神和好。”耶稣的生平显示出他的确是神应许要赐给这世界的救世主。先知以赛亚写着：“必有童女怀孕生子。”事情果然如此发生了，神借着他的全能，使玛利亚怀孕生下了耶稣。 就如经上记着，他出生的奇迹是神给的一个征兆，表明这个孩子就是弥赛亚，是神所称道的他的儿子。当人们看见了耶稣，就看见了神的形象和全能。他医治人，赦免人的罪，并且应许人在他永恒的国度里有份。耶稣牺牲他的生命， 为全人类承受刑罚，然后复活，彰显出他的全能大过死的权势。耶稣，这位弥赛亚说：“我有权柄舍了我的命，也有权柄取回来。”耶稣的生平正如先知们所写着有关于弥赛亚的生平。是的，耶稣就是神的道，借着耶稣， 神向全世界人类显明他自己。主耶稣自己也说：“天地要废去，我的话却不能废去。”起初，神创造男人和女人，使他们可以快乐地活在神的面前，但他们不相信神， 违背神的话，这种可耻的行为使他们与神分离。圣经说，世人都犯了罪，以及罪的工价乃是死。犯了罪的人是不能活在神的面前的。就如神预备一只公羊代替亚伯拉罕的儿子受死，神也赐下耶稣为亚当的后裔而死。他这么做，好让那些相信耶稣的人能重新回到神的面前。彼得说，众先知所说的就是耶稣，凡相信他的人，上帝必赦免他们的罪。因此，凡跟随耶稣的人，就能逃脱地狱的刑罚，与神永远同在。耶稣从死里复活之后，告诉跟随他的人说，人要奉我的名传悔改赦罪的道，从耶路撒冷起，直到万邦。耶稣也说，他要赐下圣灵与跟随他的人同在，引导人明白真理，赐给人力量去遵行神的道。当那犯了罪的女人悔改并且跟随耶稣的时候，耶稣对她说，你的罪赦免了，因为你相信我，所以你得救了。耶稣说，当人们真正相信神的时候，就说明了他的罪已经被赦免了。那十字架上的罪犯相信耶稣并且求耶稣救他的时候，耶稣说，今日你要与我同在乐园里了。凡决定要跟随耶稣的人，可以用下面的祷告来恢复与神亲密美好的关系。天父，你是公义的，谢谢你爱我。我真的很难过，因为违背了你的命令，犯罪得罪了你。谢谢你赐下耶稣代替我死在十字架上，又为我从死里复活。谢谢你让他为我所犯的罪受刑罚。我愿意接受耶稣做我的救主和我的主。谢谢你赦免了我的罪，为我开路，让我能够在你的国度里永远与你同在。求你将圣灵赐给我，指示我行走在你的道路上，赐给我力量全心爱你，活出一个蒙神喜悦的生命。愿全地都赞美你的圣名，阿们。耶稣论到跟随他的人说，我的羊知道我的声音，我认识他们，他们也跟从我。跟随耶稣和爱他的人都聚集在一起研读圣经，每天向耶稣祷告，学习他的榜样，并且向人传讲。耶稣赐下圣灵保惠师带领他们，坚固他们。他们牢记耶稣在升天回到宝座时曾留下应许，天上地下所有的权柄都赐给我了，所以你们要去使万民做我的门徒，我就常与你们同在，直到世界的末了。